It is now my pleasure to introduce our special guest, the young lady that I'm going to introduce to you all. Most of you know, but what you don't know is that she got her start at WGPR. She's a world star. Let me just tell you a little bit about her. She got her start at WGPR. She's also a Grammy award-winning, not a Grammy, an Emmy award-winning journalist. She's a best-selling book author, has a book that's dedicated to young women called Exactly As I Am. She was for 16 years the host of Access Hollywood. She did a lot of work on the red carpet. She's hosted the Rose Bowl Parade. She's been the person introducing people on the red carpet for many of the red carpet, the Grammys, the Oscars, and so forth. She is one of our shining stars. Very talented young lady, all the way from California. Please give a warm welcome to Miss Shaun Robinson.
You said Grammy, I was like, y'all don't want to hear me sing. Joe, thank you so much. That was such a wonderful introduction, and I appreciate everything that you have done for me and my career and being a role model and somebody who's helped me throughout the years of my first days, early days at WGPR. So thank you. Thank you so much. And Karen, thank you so much for all of this. It's absolutely, not here, but upstairs. And Mr. Dogan, thank you so much for everything that you, Mr. Howell, thank you for inviting me here. I'm not going to talk long, but I'm going to speak from my heart. I really want you to go upstairs and see the exhibit, because it's actually absolutely wonderful. Joe, after, I hadn't talked to Joe in I think maybe like 20 years, and he called me up, or emailed me, and he said, hey, we're doing this thing. I'm like, what are you doing? Okay, GPR, okay, and it's true, okay. What? Okay, that sounds cool. And when you're being a part of history, you don't realize it at the time, but then now you're looking back and we realize what history we were making. First of all, my mom's here. Mom, where are you? Hi, Mom. Back there. My father passed away this past April. He would have loved this, but I know he was looking down and cheering us all on. So his spirit is here with me this evening. I have been covering Hollywood for the last 16 years, and this is really interesting that this is happening now, because there's so much conversation about diversity in Hollywood and us not being included and not even being called to the party, not being asked to the table at all. And there was you probably heard about an actress who, former actress, who of color, black, African American, who said on Fox News that we need to do away with shows like, or channels, networks like BET, because that's the only way to get rid of segregation. Okay. I wish she were here tonight, so we could have a conversation about why this matters. I went to Spelman College in Atlanta. Historically, black colleges, you know, Morehouse College, Clark College, and Morris Brown, and yes. This, okay. But to say we didn't need to do away with networks like BET, do you also mean we need to do away with Telemundo? Do we need to do away with Univision? Do we need to do away? You know, you wouldn't say that. But it seems like when we're, once again, we are being told that we don't matter. Now, after graduating, well, after I finished my junior year, I came back home to Detroit, and I was looking for a job, and I got an internship at WGPR. I was looking for an internship at some of the major stations in town, and nobody had any internship available. So some kind of way, I ended up at WGPR and got a lot of experience that summer. Went back to Spelman after I graduated, once again, looked for jobs at the major stations in the city, and nobody would hire me. You know, nobody gave me the opportunity. But WGPR gave me the opportunity. And I started working, interning, no pay, free. And got the experience of being a reporter, got the experience of being an anchor, and got the experience of being a producer. And as a matter of fact, there's James, where's James Jackson? James, hey James. James Jackson, Big City News. And James was there at GPR before I got there, but he was really instrumental in just helping me learn to write better, helping me learn to put stories together better. And James would always look over my scripts and like, no, Shaun, you need to rewrite that. And so, but anyway, he really helped me become a better journalist. And there's so many other people here, and I want to make sure I don't miss anyone, but Joe, obviously, he was program director when I got there, right? Program director. And then I was also there, thank goodness I had the opportunity to be there with Dr. Banks, and only for a short time, but Miss Tanisha Gregory, I remember you used to always wear your hair like up in a, like a bun, didn't you? She always looked so like regal when she came into the station. She always had her hair in like a little bun and like some little tendrils, and she just always looked like really well put together, you know? But it's so wonderful seeing you after like 30 years. It is absolutely amazing seeing you. So thank you very much for the opportunity that your family gave me, in addition to the International Masons and the Sheila, her daughter, taking the picture of her mom. But anyway, some of the memories that we had, we had Coleman Young. We created this talk show called Strictly Speaking. We had Coleman Young. Do you all remember we had Coleman Young come down to the station, and everybody was wondering how did you get Coleman Young, the mayor, to come down to, to the station and talk to us and talk to a live studio audience. A lot of people wondered that. And that was because, we were putting out the stories about our community that mattered. We were in touch with the community. Folks would, say, hey, why don't you do a story on this? And so we knew from the very beginning that we had to tell the stories that nobody else was telling. And it was hard. It wasn't easy. A lot of young people today, they'll come up to me and they'll say, okay, how do I get you a job? And they think, no, let me just tell you, you can't even imagine. And the problem, and then here's one of the things. They see overnight successes, what they think are overnight successes online, on the internet, and they feel that, oh, I can just be a star tomorrow. And I tell them, yeah, you can be, but there have been so many times on the red carpet, I've been interviewing stars on the Oscar red carpet 1 year, and the next year they cannot get arrested. Okay? That's because they're in 1 year and out the other. And I tell these young people today, if you want to have longevity, you have to learn to work hard. And that's what we did at Channel 62. We were working constantly, man. My friend Rod Coffey right there in the newsroom was, hey Rod, yes. Henry McConico, sports. We really had to hustle. When we went out to press conferences with all the other bigger stations, with all the major stations, we really had to hustle because they did not want to see us. We didn't have the positions that they had. We didn't have, that kind of gravitas that we had. So we had to work extra hard to get those stories, to make our connections, to go out and hustle, get the story, and then come back and put it together, put the 3/4-inch tapes together and put them in the, So even today, when I'll do a stand-up or something, you know, they do it, it's all digital now, but I'll do a stand-up and then I'll say, let's do it again in case there's a wrinkle in the tape. Because a lot of times, this is Mr. Dogan. This is not a, I'm not saying anything about the equipment. But we used to have these big 3/4-inch tapes, and we had to use them over and over and over again. We had to economize, okay? Because we had to use the tapes over and over again. And so a lot of times there would be a big wrinkle in the tape. So like your best stand-up, there might be a big wrinkle in the tape, so you had to do that stand-up a few times, okay? But I'm telling you, we had to hustle when we were out there. And I think about all the stars, the celebrities that came through. Prince would come through the station. Who, where are some of our DJs in the audience? Where, who, wait, who, there's a DJ, some of our DJs, WGPR DJs, what? Rockin' Reg. We had Prince coming through there. We had like everybody stopped by WGPR because it was the place to be. You know, who? Seinfeld came through? Okay, we had Seinfeld, we had like, and Nat Morris, with Nat, don't try to leave. Let me just say this, Nat, you are just a part of our childhood. You were our Don Cornelius. Detroit is my home. Even though I live out in LA, Detroit is, it runs through my veins, and I am so proud. A lot of people say, oh, I'm from Southfield. No, I tell people I am from Detroit, Michigan. And I got my start at the first black-owned television station in the country. And I remember I live in LA, and there were these neighbors that when I moved into my first house, there were these neighbors that were living across the street, people who were not of color, but I went over there, and the lady had these black and white pictures on her wall. I went over, hi, I'm Sean, I'm the new neighbor. And I look at us, and the pictures were of like these kids with like dirt on their faces, their clothes torn, walking and like no shoes on, anything. I was like, oh my God, these photographs are extraordinary. I was like, what, thinking like she went to, you know, I don't know, Afghanistan, yeah. What do you say? Yeah, so, no, well, they were, and she goes, oh, I'm a photographer. photographer. I took those in the slums of Detroit. And I said, what street? I'm from Detroit. I've never stayed there. Where is that? Oh, well, you know, you can't, whatever, okay. So, when I go places, don't diss my city, okay? Because I will call you out on it. I will call you out. You know how much time LA has? I mean, there are parts of LA that I would never go in. Are you kidding me? Okay? So, you know, whenever, if I could just leave it, it says, you know, wherever we are, speak good things about our city. Speak good things about our station, our history, and our community, because we mean a lot to a lot of people. And I want to make sure that I got everybody else. Dr. Lynn Lewis is here. She was a guest of ours on Strictly Speaking. What was the topic?
Older women, younger men.
And Sheila was our producer, one of our fabulous producers. And, you know, coming back, putting those stories together, getting them on the air on time. So it was so good to see you again, Tommy. It was so good to see you. So, okay, I'm going to wrap this up. I just want to make sure I did not forget anybody. Did I forget anybody? Please raise your hand. I forgot you. Okay, all right. So, everybody, I love you. I love being back here. Thank you once again for giving me the opportunity to start my career in my city so my parents could watch me on TV and be very proud. That meant the world to me. So thank you. Thank you so much. Thank you. And Amir Makeup said, I mean, I've watched this lady on TV for so many years. You were one of my role models. I would finish my cartoons when I was little. Kimba the White Lion, Flintstones, Addams Family, The Jetsons, and after that, the news would come on, and my grandmother had to turn to Beverly Payne. Remember Beverly Payne? And she was the only person that looked like me on TV other than Buckwheat, who I just saw on the Little Rascals. And so I would see her and say, oh gosh, I want to do that. But then growing up, I would watch Amir on TV all the time. First of all, you look the same. And thank you.